Good morning, student. I'm Rose. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is Standard 6, History, Chapter 10, Life in Villages and Towns. Okay, so in the last chapter you have learned about the different kings and the kingdoms, and you have learned about the largest empire which emerged during the later Vedic period, which was called as the Magadha. Okay, so in that you have learned about the different lifestyles of the people, or the people who live in different areas of India, or different kingdom. Okay, that you learn. Okay, today in this chapter you will learn about how was the life in villages and town in later Vedic period. What was the life in villages and town in later Vedic period? Okay, so first of all we will learn about the life in villages. What was the people's life in the villages? Okay, so mainly the people of villages, you know how they usually are the farmers, carpenters, blacksmith, or we can say there are carpenters, weavers. These are the people who live in villages. Okay? Yes or no? So same as this, we will categorize into two. That means, first of all, we learn about the North India. The people maybe who live in North India were categorized into three particular ways. Okay? So that means the people who used to have so much big land, or we can say agricultural field, and on large sum of land, they were called as the Gram Pojaka. That kind of farmers were known as the Gram Pojaka, and he was often called as the largest landowner. He was often called as the largest landowner because under him, because vast area of agricultural field comes under him, and he owned a large part of the land. Okay, and he used this agricultural field by cultivate or produce the crops by means of hiring a different slaves or the different landless animals to different landless people to work for him. Okay, so this is how this Gram Pojaka, and due to he was so much rich in the villages, sometimes they used to make him as a zamindar, and he used to consider he sometimes become one of the leader of the particular villages, and this leader used to also collect the taxes, and even he stands as a judge or as the policeman. He even stands as the judge and the policeman in the particular villages. Okay, so this was one kind. Another type of farmers are called as the Grihapatis. Okay, these are the people or the farmers who were having a small amount of land. Okay, and they doesn't need any to hire any slaves or any landless people to work for him. Okay, they do their agricultural works by themselves. Okay, so they were so much independent. Next were the Dasa Karmaka. Under them comes the people who are not having the lands, or because they are landless people, or the people who contain so much small amount of land. Okay, and these people depend on other rich farmers like we say Gram Pojaka, because they live their livelihood by working under them. Okay, so these were the kinds of people who usually live in the villages in North India. Okay, next were the South India. If you talk about life in the South, life of people in villages in South India, if you talk about same as the North India, it were also divided into three. That means the people or the villagers or the farmers who were so much rich and having so much large amount of land, they were called as the Vilalas. And the small amount of small landlords were having, or the small farmers, were called as the Uchavar. And the people who were so much landless and having a small amount of land, they were called as the Kadyasiyar, or we can say Adimai, or we call the Adimai. Okay, so these kind of people were living in the villages, okay, in the later Vedic period. So, for the livelihood, what were the occupation they used to do? Main occupation of the villages, you know, that is the agriculture and the crafts. Okay, so in the later Vedic period, so much changes happened in the field of agriculture. What are the changes, or what are the things happened during the later Vedic period? Okay, so here some of the method which was being originated or which was being discovered in the later Vedic period. First of all, okay, use of iron tools. Use of iron tools. Okay, so there were so many iron tools, or they started to discover, they started to make different iron tools for agriculture purpose. For example, ploughing. Ploughing, they need a iron plough shear. Iron plough shear. Okay, so this plough shear, what happened? They used to plough the field and it makes the soil so much manure and fertile. Manure and fertile. Due to that, what happened? The productivity of the crops which was being produced in the field was so much high. So much high. Okay, now another thing, as they started to make the sickles, axles. Okay, so these are the things they used to, axles was the main problem, but they used to clear the forest for the agriculture land, and the sickles were used for the cutting or harvesting of the crops. Okay, so this was how the one of the most important methods or development or discovery happened in later Vedic period. Next is the transplantation of the plants. Transplantation of the plants. Okay, so in the later Vedic period, they started to transplant the crops. Okay, transplant means if they have sowing the seed in one place, what happened? When it grows into a small plant, they will pluck in all the crops and they will transfer to different paddy field. Okay, so this kind of transplantation happened. And what is the main specialty of the transplantation happened is the productivity of the crops increased, and the crops or the food which was being produced by the cultivation also increased. Okay, next is the irrigation. Irrigation means there was also a development in irrigation purpose. Irrigation means there were different means, like as a ponds, wells, then you have hand pumps, artificial lakes. Okay, so these are the important irrigation tanks or the water reservoir they started to make. Due to that, what happened? The fertility or the crops which was being produced was so much increased. Okay, so these was the changes happened in the later Vedic period. Another one was the craft. There were different craft person in the different villages. Okay, and they were the porters, weavers, carpenters, blacksmith, goldsmith, garland maker, basket maker. Okay, so these are the people who are engaged in ivory of making and bead making. Okay, so these are the people who mainly live. These are the extra activities which is done in the villages, and these are the people who use for their livelihood for making the pot. Potters make the pots, weavers make the clothes, carpenters they used to make the doors and windows, blacksmith for making jewelries. These are the people also live in the villages, and they use the different methods for their livelihood. Okay, so today we are going to learn this much. In the next video, I'll tell you about the life in the towns and what are the things they use for their livelihood. Thank you for now.